Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back. My name is Nadia Sands. This, of course, is Learn How to Edit Stuff. And today, I'm going to absolutely blow your f***ing minds with the coolest machine learning, AI, visual effects, and editing technology that I've seen in a very, very long time. And it is called Runway ML. Have you heard of Runway ML before? If not, this video is going to change your life and, again, blow your f***ing mind. And what do I ask in return for such an incredible video? Anyone? Anyone? Just for you to subscribe, drop a comment in the comment section below, give this video a thumbs up. Only if you enjoyed it, though. If you enjoy my content, do all that stuff. If you don't come anywhere near me. All right, so without further ado, let's jump into Runway ML. If you go right now to runwayml.com, it will take you to a website that looks exactly like this, because this is the website. And there's gonna be two things that we're gonna explore today. Number one is this green screen functionality that they have built with AI machine learning awesomeness. And number two, a thing called SQL, which is just launching today, I think. As I'm putting this video out, it is coming out into public beta. And a little caveat to all of this stuff, it is still in working beta. The technology, the foundation of all this stuff is absolutely incredible, and I'm so excited to show you guys this today. But keep in mind, it is still in beta, so it's always constantly being worked on, and I personally am working with the developers to kind of like hone it in and really like, you know, just kind of tighten it all up a little bit. Very exciting stuff. Now at the top of the webpage, you're gonna see something that says pricing. And if you click on that, don't worry. There is a free option for you, okay? Unlimited green screen SD exports. So it's all in 720p. If you wanna get 1080 or 4K exports, you do have to pay for it. You can pay annually, which comes out to $28 a month, all billed at once, or monthly, which is $35 a month. But you will see time is money, and this saves a tremendous amount of time, but there is a free option for you. So go ahead and sign up for Runway ML. And once you do that, go to log in and it will take you to a page that looks something like this. We are going to dive into SQL in just a moment, but first we're gonna start off by going to our assets and uploading a video from our computer. So I'm gonna click upload right here, go to upload files, and I'm going to drop in this clip of a dancer flipping. Click open and it will upload. All right, this is not the amazing tech. This is just a regular upload progress bar, but we're gonna do all this in real time just to let you know that there's no editing tricks, no nothing. This thing works as fast as real time. It's gonna be great. We are finished uploading. It is at 100%. There you go. Here is our clip right there. So now that I've got that done, I'm gonna go over to green screen and you will see that my dancer flip has appeared in my library. There are some other videos for you to check out if you want to experiment with the ones that they give you. But for this tutorial, we're doing it ourselves. So I'm gonna take this clip, drag and drop it down onto my timeline. And then it will give me a little plus button down here where my video is. And I'm just gonna click on my dancer a couple times to let the technology know what I wanna rotoscope, and it just rotoscopes it instantly. Again, this is not, no editing, picture in picture this. We're gonna do all this in real time, no cuts, I promise. So I've gone ahead and clicked on my dancer. I'm gonna click preview. And what it's gonna do is it's gonna analyze my clip and then it's gonna rotoscope out the entire thing. Look, done already. Look at how clean that mask is now. I know what you're thinking. Oh, the mask breaks a little bit. Okay, find where your mask breaks. Not a big deal. We're just gonna set a keyframe. Boom, click on it once. You'll see that it sets a keyframe right down here at the bottom and it fills in the rest of our mask. You can control and scroll wheel into your video so you can zoom in a little bit just to get some of those problem areas. You can also click and drag around by holding space bar, and you could also exclude stuff by clicking on exclude or two on your keyboard. So two to exclude, one to include. That's really all I'm gonna do for this because that's looking pretty good. And then I will just click preview one more time and it will finish out my mask, grabbing those problem areas and create a very fast, very clean rotoscope in literally a matter of seconds. Okay, we haven't cut this whole time, and look at this, unbelievable. Okay, so now that we have that, what we can do is we can come over here to export, and then don't forget to click on feather mask right here just so it smooths it out just a little bit around the edges. And you can choose to export it on green screen or blue screen or fuchsia screen or orange or yellow. Okay, anyway, that's all the colors. You can do it on a background of clouds. You can do it on a background of the ocean if you want. But usually what people will do is just do the green screen. You can also export an alpha matte that you can drag and drop into After Effects to kind of like do some cool like alpha matte situation. But for this video, we are going to export it on green screen. You can include audio with your export as well. And I do pay for the, you know, premium version. So we're gonna go 1920 by 1080 on this. Boom, export video. It will kick you back over into your asset library and it will just be in progress. Now it is processing that video. And what I'm gonna do now is open up Adobe After Effects, because I'm gonna wanna key out that green screen anyway. And I know what you're thinking, oh, you still have to use After Effects or Premiere to key out the green screen. Okay, first of all, Let's calm down for a second. You can send that green screen footage to somebody. You can key it out yourself. You can bring it into an editor that's not Premiere or After Effects. You can do it in DaVinci Resolve. But the little coup de grace, the little cherry on top of all this, is I'm talking to the developers and I say, hey, you should definitely make it so that you can just export an alpha channel out of RunwayML so that I don't have to bring it into a third-party software to key it out in the first place. And so they are actively working on that. So very exciting. A lot of really, really cool stuff in the works with that development team. And I'm super stoked to be getting to work with them on developing it. I'm not a developer, but I have cool ideas, so now I'm a developer. Anyway, we're gonna open up this After Effects project right here because I went ahead and I rotoscoped out using Rotobrush 2, the original video, and put a green screen behind it. So this is not the Runway ML version. This is the Rotobrush 2 version, all right? And you guys know I like Rotobrush 2 a lot, but it took me 30 minutes to get halfway through a 3 second clip. And guys, I really did try at the beginning. Like I was going frame by frame and it was painstaking. Let's roll the B-roll because I recorded it. And I was just running into so many issues and so many little things. And by the time I got to a second and a half, I gave up. And I was like, all right, I'm just gonna let this thing auto-propagate in Rotobrush 2. And as you can see, his foot is missing and it's just like really clunky and it just doesn't look great. So here's the side-by-side comparison to Runway ML on the right and Rotobrush 2 on the left. Runway ML does a significantly better job in like 1/24th of the time. It is wild. But I will say, as a professional, if you're gonna rotoscope something and you want more control over the rotoscope, you're still gonna wanna use something like After Effects or Rotobrush 2 because they do give you significantly more control choices like feathering, contrast, shifting edge, reducing chatter, using motion blur, decontaminate edges, the refine edge brush, all of that stuff comes with Rotobrush 2. And right now on the Runway ML side, it's just one little click box that says feather mask. It does a pretty good job anyway. So if you're just making memes or you just want to extract something really quick from a scene and do it in like literally no time at all, Runway ML is gonna be your best friend. Don't tell Adobe this, but Runway ML is gonna be my best friend. Man, this technology is so cool and I'm super stoked. Okay, real quick, before we dive into SQL, let's go back over into Runway ML. And I'm just gonna show you one more real quick. Go to green screen, and I found this footage of this girl kind of like jumping and walking past a wall that's exactly the same as her skin tone and exactly the same as her sweater. And so this would be a really, you know, problem thing for machine learning to figure out, right? But just a couple clicks, again, all in real time. We're not trying to do anything fancy. Grab her boot and her leg. And for what it's worth, the machine learning and everything, it works based on like depth maps and stuff. We're already done. So picture in picture again. This did a really, really, really good job in literally 2 seconds. I couldn't even explain how the AI tech worked in the amount of time that it took to do this thing. So we can come over here to export and then we can export it on a green screen. Again, feather your mask so it looks a little bit better on the back end. And this has just done a really fantastic job, super, super fast. And I am very, very impressed. And I usually don't get impressed with stuff like this when people claim that they have amazing AI tech for video editing. I usually am like, huh. But the developers reached out to me, they emailed me and they were like, can you check this out? And I looked at it and I was absolutely blown away. So very excited for the future. But now let's dive into SQL, which is kind of one step cooler than the green screen. So I'm gonna come back to home and we're going to start a new project up here in SQL. And again, I'm just going to drag my dancer flip right down here onto my timeline. And I'm gonna zoom in holding control and the mouse wheel. And then the first thing I'm gonna do is right click and go to duplicate. So now I have two copies of that video and I'm gonna click on the top copy here and go to magic tools and click on green screen. And we are going to use the same AI masking technology that we did in the green screen video. Click preview, let it do its thing. We're gonna have to redo the mask again because it's gonna break in the same exact spot. Same tech, same workflow. Nope, there we go, right about there. Click on that guy, it'll get his arm too because it does a really nice job. I'm not gonna zoom in on his hat this time. Cool, I know that that's exactly what I want, so I'm gonna go to save mask. And it's going to save the alpha channel layer on top of the original video. So in SQL, I'm just gonna pull this over for now just so we can see what we're doing. I can come over here and I can blur. Get out of here, NVIDIA. Okay, thank you. So I can come over here and I can actually blur the mask significantly more, and I have manual blur control over the outside feathering of my mask in SQL. So that's pretty cool. I can also turn on the threshold, which is gonna be like your grow and shrink kind of choke mat along the outside. And when combined with blur, you can kind of do it all like that. So definitely mess around with this, play with it to your heart's content. You can invert the mask For if you wanted to do that for whatever reason, you can also apply and unapply the mask. And you can also add effects to this. So down here, Gaussian blur, brightness and contrast, you can do it with a fill color if you wanted to make an iPhone commercial from, you know, back in the early 2000s. There's a bunch of color grading options here. So there's a bunch of stuff to play with because Sequel is kind of built as a compositing tool. So what we can do is just drag this back over onto our original video. Check this out. So I'm gonna right click, duplicate, and then drag that alpha layer up on top of itself two more times so I have three different copies of my video. And then on this middle layer right here, I'm just gonna click and drag over to the right. And then on my top layer here, I'm gonna click and drag over to the left. I messed up those directions. Click and drag over to the left, click and drag over to the right. And then I'm just gonna apply some effects to my duplicates. So come down here to effects, and maybe we're gonna add a modern times onto that guy. And then we'll add a modern times onto the other guy. And I have now effectively duplicated my dancer here, and it is masked out on both sides, and I'm applying effects to the outside layers. And I am doing something very, very quickly that would take me a very long time to do in Adobe After Effects, and it took no time at all. And mind you, I'm on a website. This is all web-based. Again, still in beta, we're getting some little ghosting here or whatever, but this is a website! You can do this from a potato, absolute dog shit computer because it is using cloud computing and everything that they have on their end from a web browser. That is power that is, God, I'm such a nerd, but this is so cool. This is like literally one of the coolest things that I've seen in a very long time. So I'm done talking about it. I want you guys to go experience Runway ML for yourself and Sequel, which I think is coming out today in public beta, and also the green screen functionality. So go to runwayml.com, sign up for your free account, okay? No cost to you, no cost to me, no cost to nobody. Just sign up for free, use the unlimited SD exports, and really just play around with this stuff. Play around with the test projects, upload your own footage, impress your friends, get them on a green screen, send it to them. It's gonna be really fun, and I am genuinely happy that I get to tell you guys this information because this is stuff that really excites me, and I hope that you're also excited. And with that note, I am going to end the video. By the way, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, I would really appreciate it if you do so. It is free to you. It is awesome for me. So down below, you'll find a subscribe button, a thumbs up button, and a comment section. Drop a comment in the comment section below. Let me know what you think of Runway ML and how you are going to use it in your video editing and visual effects workflow. In the video description, you will find obviously the Runway ML website and also a Linktree link, which will take you to a bunch of different links of companies that I support, that they support me, that I think are really good for creators, Epidemic Sound, and Otto Elements, AE Juice, all of that good stuff. Runway ML is for sure going to go in the Linktree link now. Links to all my social media, join the Discord. All of that stuff is in the Linktree link. Tons of goodies always, guys. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for commenting. Thank you for liking and helping the YouTube algorithm get my videos in front of more people that are really super cool just like you. That about does it today for me, guys. And I will see you in the next one.